students. This is Shalini, Assistant Professor of English, St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science, Kadalur. This video is for the paper Indian English Literature. In this video, we are going to see the drama Silence the Court is in session. This drama was written by Vijay Tendulkar. Vijay Tendulkar was born on January 6, 1928. He was died on May 19, 2008. He was a leading Indian playwright, movie and television writer, literary essayist, political journalist and social commentator, primarily in Marathi. He is best known for his plays Shantata Kochalu Ahe, Hashiram Kotwal and Shakharam Binder. Many of Vijay Tendulkar's plays derived inspiration from real-life incidents or social upheavals, which provides clear light on harsh realities. He has provided guidance to students studying playwriting in U.S. universities. Tendulkar had been highly influential dramatist and theatre personality in Maharashtra for over five decades. The rise of Shiv Sena in Maharashtra in 1970s, it was reflected in Tendulkar's Hashiram Kotwal, the true story of a journalist who purchased of a woman from the rural sex industry to reveal police and political involvement in this trade. It only to abandon the woman once he had no further need for her is a detailed in Tendulkar's Kamala. The play was later made into a film, Kamala. The real life story of an actress whose acting career got ruined after her same-sex affair became public knowledge inspired Tendulkar to write Mitrachi Hosta. Besides the foregoing, Tendulkar's oeuvre includes a biography, two novels, five anthologies of short stories, 16 plays for children, including Bail Miltet and Patlacha Porchi Lagin, and five volumes of literary essays and social criticism, including Ratrani, Kavali Unhe, Appuchi, Sofanchi. All in all, Tendulkar's writing have contributed to a significant transformation of modern literary landscape in Marathi and other Indian languages. Let's move on to the story, Silence the Court is in Session. In the Act 1, Samanth and Banner unlock and enter an empty meeting hall. Samanth carries a lock and key, a toy parrot and a book. Samanth moves the conversation to a magic show he saw in the meeting hall. As Samanth talks about, Banner moves close to him and asks him about the performance. Samanth still wants to talk about the magician, but Banner has moved on. She is a school teacher and, in reference to her delayed colleagues, insists that she has never been late to school or fallen behind in her lessons. Banner's mood brightens again and she begins to wander around the room. Samanth suggests she sit down, but Banner explains that when she is teaching, she never sits down. Banner places her hand on her stomach as she delivers her monologue. As she trails off, Samanth stands awkward and embarrassed. He offers to go find the rest of the troupe, but Banner asks him to stay. She does not like being alone. Banner wonders if Samanth understands the event happening that evening. He knows it has something to do with the court, and Samanth clarifies it's a living courtroom whose goal is spreading enlightenment. Banner begins to joke about the fellow members of her troupe, calling Miss Kashikar, Mrs. Hand That Rocks the Cradle, although she has no child, insulting Rakde, whom she says the Kashikars have turned into a slave, and mocking Sugantame's unpopular law practice and Pongshe's academic failings. Finally, Banner notes there is an intellectual who refuses to face real problems but who will not be attending today. Benner and Samantha hide behind a door as the others arrive, carrying suitcases, a microphone, and other costumes and equipment. They jump out in surprise, but only Benner finds it funny. Sugantami jokes that Benner is a child at heart and does not want to grow up. Benner insists that as a teacher she is very serious, but that everyone should take be joyful when they can. Benner changes the conversation and asks Samant to start setting up chairs. Samant, who has set up some of the chairs, addresses Pankshe as a sahib and tells him to sit. Pankshe is flattered but declines. Act 2 begins exactly where Act 1 left off. Kashika repeats the last line of the previous act, asking Benner if she is guilty of infanticide. Benner, still in shock from the accusation, she does not answer. Samant has arrived with pan and cigarettes. He hands them out. Sugantami tries to offer some to Benner, but she declines, flustered. Sugantami proposes that the court take a 15-second break to spit out the pan. The men discuss the amount of time needed. Criticizing Benner, when she interjects, they talk for over a minute and a half. Kashika hears her and bangs his gavel, complaining that she cannot shut up at home. She cannot shut up here. Mrs. Kashika protests, but Sugantami cuts her off. He arguing Kashikar was just joking. Karnik urges her to be serious so Samant can better understand the court. Sugantami adds they need to be serious, otherwise this game becomes really childish. Benner pleads not guilty, arguing she could not even kill a cockroach. Rogday sets up a book for oath taking and a witness box. Sugantami, stretched out lazily while smoking, delivers the prosecution's speech. He begins, "Motherhood is a sacred thing, a pure thing that gives much responsibility to a woman." Benner interrupts, wondering how he knows anything about motherhood, but Kashikar reprimands her and Sugantami continues. Sugantami argues that given the status of motherhood, infanticide is the most devilish thing on earth, and he aims to prove Benner is guilty. Sugantami grills Pankshe on his relationship to Benner. Pankshe describes her as a school mom, which Benner protests as she is still quite young. Act 3 resumes where Act 2 left off. Sugantami and Kashika speaking more formally than in the previous acts. Usher Benner to the witness box. She will not move. Sugantami puts on his lawyer gown and urges Kashika to put on her judge's robes. As they dress, their gravity and dignity increase. Mrs. Kashika places Benner's hand on the dictionary, and though she still will not speak, Mrs. Kashikar argues they should continue. Sugantami begins to question her, although she remains silent. Sugantami asks her age, and Mrs. Kashikar guesses 32, but Kashikar won't accept the estimation. When Benner refuses to answer yet, again Kashikar decides she is not less than 34. Kashikar gives a short speech about reviving child marriage in order to curb promiscuity. He argues that Agarkar and Dandu Keshav Kaur, two social reformers and women's welfare activists, have ruined society. Sugantami asks Benner how she has managed to remain unmarried at such a mature, advanced age. She remains silent even as Kashika yells at her. Sugantami decides to call a new witness. Mrs. Kashika is called to the stand. Kashikar marks her for being over-eager. Sugantami asks Mrs. Kashikar. She thinks Benner has remained unmarried. Mrs. Kashikar believes it must have been a choice, and Benner could have married if she wanted. Benner and Samanth are remain on stage. Samanth goes to collect the cloth parrot he brought with him. He hesitates before leaving and sets the parrot down respectfully near Benner. Although she remains silent and still, her voice begins to sing from the speaker in the theatre. The speakers play a song from earlier in which a parrot asks a sparrow why she is crying, and she says her nest has been stolen. They ask a crow if he has seen where it went, but he has not, and asks, "What are you troubles to do with me?" The light changes, illuminating only Benner. The curtain falls.